It's so weird. So, hola, ¿qué tal?
Bonjour.
Bonjour. So, it's the first time I tried to make this kind of video. So,
I feel kind of celebrity.
Yeah, it's kind of weird. For sure, we're gonna speak in English because we don't speak the same language.
Unfortunately.
Yeah, I wanted to speak about our trip to Canada because we went to an English school last year and we have a lot of things to tell you, and if it can help you, if you want to have the same experience, so maybe, yeah, it can be good to make this kind of video. I think we'd be the only one in my channel because it's not that kind of stuff. But, so let's go.
All the stuff behind us, it's okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's moving?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Let's start the video. So you need to do this one.
Okay.
To put the context. So we came in Toronto. It's like one of the big cities, the biggest city in Canada, I think.
Yeah, like a financial city.
Yeah, and we came for English course in like an international school in ILAC. And I came with an organization. It's WEP in Belgium. And I don't know, you came alone?
Yeah, no, with an agency.
Ah, agency too. So yeah, we came with an agency, but you can just register to the school in the ILAC website. Maybe it can be cheaper. So yeah, you can start if you want. So why you decide to come to Canada?
In Canada, well, I decided first because I want to improve more my English. Before, I was shy. So I needed to go to a country with the first language is English, sorry, and to improve it. So I went to ILAC in Toronto.
Yeah, for me I came, yeah, the same for English because my English was terrible. Like in high school, like I was always the last
it's
of my
still
class.
Terrible, but
thank you. I was the last of my class and all my English teacher like didn't like me so much. And yeah, after I was finishing a bachelor, my bachelor in communication in Belgium, and yeah, I really didn't know what to do with my life. I was like, okay, I don't know what to do now. I'm like totally lost. And after I spent like it was like the worst year of my life. Like this year was super hard for me because I got a lot of personal problems. So I was really, like I finished my year, I was really, really bad. I was so lost. I said, yeah, maybe I can go to Canada. I don't know why Canada. And like during 3 years, I prepared my trip to Canada. And so, yeah, that's why, like Canada changed a lot my life. After well, we started
the
year. Beginning of adventure. So we're gonna talk about this after. How was the school of ILAC and like
in the first
the activities?
Well, I went to there. I was a little bit afraid because I was alone at that time. You know that I went to Toronto at first time with a friend, but she came. She went to another school, so I went alone to ILAC and I was a little bit afraid for that. But the first weeks was good because I started to meet new people of all the countries, most of them of Brazil. My class was like 70% of Brazilian people.
And over Japanese.
Yeah, Japanese, Asian people. I thought that I was the only Mexican in that class, in my first class. So it was good. I start to make new friends, and in the second one it was better because I start to get used to the classes, to the people, because all of them are new. Nobody come like together, so everyone is meeting each other.
Yeah, it's always good because like you're very alone. Like the first day, you're very, very alone. Like I think I cried during like 1 week, and
really?
You were telling me the same. Yeah, because it was the first time I traveled alone, and I was like, I didn't know the city alone. I don't know why I went to Toronto because I didn't know the city. I was like, okay, I'm in a big city because it's a big change for me.
Yeah, I know.
And after I was so alone, my English was so bad, so I was like, okay,
maybe
complicated. And after, when you start to meet people at ILAC, like, become very, yeah, really better.
Yeah, because you start to make new friends, because in ILAC there are a lot of activities.
Mm, yeah, it's cool. It's when I met Miwa, it was, we were together with a Japanese girl, so always together. And when I met her, it was, yeah, because I like organize some activity. So one Belgian friend, so Titoon, if you come here, bisous bisous. And yeah, he proposed me to go to a place, but an activity of ILAC. And we asked Miwa to come with us. And it's like this that you met people. Like, you need to think that everybody is alone. So we are, everybody is the same situation. So just ask two people to come with you in an activity. You can go to travel, because ILAC organize a lot of travel, like New York. You went to Chicago.
Yeah, I went to Chicago, to New York.
Yeah, and she was alone when she went, and you met people.
Yeah, I met people in that trip. It was so good.
Yeah, that's why. So you're never really alone. Just don't be shy, and yeah, go to meet people, and try to don't speak with people of your country.
Yeah,
it's the worst, because in the beginning.
Yeah, I know. Yeah. If you meet people of your country, try to practice your English, please. Because he was with a Belgian guy too. They don't, bisous bisous, and they always were talking in French. And so like, okay, nice. I didn't understand anything, of course. So they need to talk in French first, and after they need to translate what they say.
Yeah, I know it's like, it's easy way like to make new friends in the beginning, because you're like, oh my god, there is like a Belgian guy, or oh, a French people, and you feel not alone, but
yeah,
no, really, don't stay with, I know it's hard, but don't stay with the people of your country. And it's how you practice your English. Just go to other people, and they have the same level with you, because what is good in ILAC is when you start, you make an exam, and after we decide which class you will go. And everybody in the class, we are not a lot, and everybody in the class speak the same, have the same level of English. So it's really nice, because you're not shy to speak with, like, everybody has the same level. Like, our level with me, I was terrible at
meeting. Our English were worse than now. Still worse.
It's not... Yeah, it's not perfect, but yeah, in the beginning it's hard, so it's good to be with some people, like, alone, and they speak the same language.
Because you start to be confident. Mm-hmm. For me, it doesn't matter if sometimes I make mistakes, but I don't care about this now, because I can notice when I make a mistake, and I can correct after.
Yeah, that's why. And the teacher in ILAC, I think it's the best part of ILAC, it's the teacher. Like, wow, teachers are very nice. Like, my first teacher was like, yeah, I remember, I hope I like really don't see this video. My first teacher was like, go to parties. It's how you can practice your English. Like,
oh, that's true.
Yeah, we don't care about homework. Go to party, go make friends, go. And I think that we listen so much with teacher, because every week we were in party. But we improve our English like this, because you're always with people, you always speak English, so. Yeah, don't come back home after school, just go out.
You need to go out to discover outdoors.
Yeah. There's too many things to do in city in Toronto. Like, every day we find something, and not just coffee. Like, I remember every Monday, like, together we were searching a coffee, good coffee, and every Monday we were searching a new place. It was the coffee day. So, but it's good, because you go out and yeah, you
are practicing your English.
Yeah. So yeah, for me, ILAC was really nice, and yeah, the kind of activity you can do. For example, so you have trip for sure, like Niagara Falls. Niagara Falls was good, because I was kind of alone too, so I met people there. It was super nice. So Niagara Falls. You have New York, Chicago. Montreal.
French part of Canada, the French part. Ottawa, Montreal, and Quebec.
Yeah. So
and you go there in the weekend.
Yeah.
The trip starts in. You go in a bus. At night, a Friday night, and you come back Monday. I think. Yeah. Monday night.
So yeah, really, it's really nice to meet people. It's not so expensive, because I think we have discounts.
Yeah, kind
of. So yeah, you can do this kind of
thing. I think it's worth, really.
Yeah, it's worth it. And after what you can do is like, they organize a lot of like activity like a party. The party of my life are really nice.
Yeah, that's cool. Always organize kind of party.
Yeah, party with, because there is a lot of students. So they organize party with just the students of ILOC. So imagine, it's really nice. Mm-hmm. After they organize like karaoke, board games, nights. Yeah, this kind of stuff. We went to Sky Zone, it's like a trampoline, a big trampoline park. And all this kind of stuff is really, really nice. So after, we're gonna speak about homestay with my partner. Okay, so homestay. So it's not a thing.
My gosh.
Okay. It's not time.
You're sorry, we are not professional.
We just tried. Okay, so we were speaking about homestay.
The people in my homestay were so young. They were like kind of my brother because they were like 27. A couple of Brazil. It was nice because I paid for the 3 meals.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah. they asked me what I like and they cook me like traditional Brazilian food or pizza, whatever I want. And they told me you can cook whatever you want in the fridge right here.
Yeah,
nice. All the kitchen is yours.
They're like a real family. Yeah. Because you need to keep in mind that homestay can be complicated because it's like you are lucky or you are not. So because I have we have a lot of friends who were not so lucky about homestay because they don't know where we go. There is a residence too. So you can decide if you go homestay or residence, and homestay you can choose I think the like how many meals you want in the day. So for us it was like 3 meals, so that's nice because we didn't need to care about this. And after you need to be lucky, but if you have a good homestay I think can be really nice. Like my homestay was like I really love my homestay and they are like my second family. So if they come here, please visit too. My homestay make like adventure better because they show me a lot of things. Like we had like weekend dinner. When I was my birthday they prepared like they give me like a big cake, big chocolate cake. They organized
my Christmas. I didn't know that. Nice.
Sorry. If you want to know for the price,
it's around 800 to 900 per month.
But depends on the people, but just to give you like a range of number.
Yeah,
a range of price. You can start like with a homestay and after just look for yourself. Yeah, you have choice, so you're not blocking a homestay. So the first day, in ILOC. How was it?
Well, as I told you before, I was a bit afraid. To find the class was easy because you need to go to the school first. Mm-hmm. What's a little weird because I told you I was the only Mexican. But you have to know I thought that I was the youngest.
Oh really?
Yeah, in that class, there were a lot of not older people, but older than me. Like
people are not 30, so old, but
30 something.
Yeah, me too. I was always like the youngest. But after it's good because people are in the same mood, so you don't care about the age of people. Yeah. Just because now I have friends of 26, 27, and I had just 23, so and it's not a problem. Like people are very nice in Toronto, so don't care about the age. Yeah, the first day was like. I remember I was so afraid. I entered my little class, I was like so shy. And after I met Osan. Yeah, Osan and Raphael. So we were like new together. And people in my class are very nice because then I met Titun the first day. It's a Belgian guy. I know it's not good, but can help you in the beginning because he gave me a lot of advice. And after invite me to party with the class and everything. And my first class, I think my first class was one of the best, like this one. And after when we were together, because we met after in another class.
In the second month.
Yeah, because you you need to pass exam, and after you enter a new class with a new level, and you met again new people. So you met. You met always new people.
And when you go to the other level, you have another class with new people again.
So it's good. It's good and not good because like you met people, so you're like friends. And after you need to change the class again to start again to make new friends.
But it's good because you still have the same friends and you can.
And you can like
in the rest and like in the lunchtime you can go with your friends for the other class.
Yeah, and it's funny because your group. Start to become like bigger because we were like three in the beginning with my class, and after I met Alice and Ali we were together with Miwa, and after we met other people in our next class, like we went with Kevin, and we have like our little group. So yeah, you meet people every time, and yeah, it's really nice. I think I will pull up the camera.
We can continue with
where we are now.
When we met and how?
Well, we were in the second round, as I told you before. Unfortunately, I met this girl in my second class. We were together.
Yeah.
We were new. We were again afraid. Like, okay, new people. She was like sad because she met Miwa, and she wanted to be with Miwa in the same class.
I was really sad in the second class. I was like, oh my gosh, like I'm alone again.
I was alone too.
But when you met, because my first class was really really nice. So after, when you need to leave people and start again, you're like depressing. But after, I think the first day I was so shy, I didn't speak to anybody. And I remember you were with another girl and I was a little bit shy. So yeah, we didn't speak too much in the class.
Because
we met
our friend Miwa, in lunchtime she came to the class and she spoke with her. And I was like, alone, like, okay, lunchtime, me alone.
But after was better because it was funny because we took the same bus, so we met in the bus. We really met in the bus because she was not living so far from my house, and she was in the bus, and in the beginning we were so shy, we were just say, oh hi, how are you? That's it.
Yeah, it was like I know that girl. I was like, oh hi.
We're in the same class,
but
we can
go together to the class.
And after we start to speak, I think we start to speak in the bus. More and
after in lunchtime, can I sit with you?
We were sitting together. And after I remember I wanted to plan the damn, you're free. Look into your heart and you'll find love, love, love. Because we went up together, just together.
Really?
And after I said, I can introduce you to supermarket with me. Well, we were just together, and after I say, I'm going with another friends to Christmas market. And you say, I can come. I said, for sure. We asked Miwa. And we went out together. She met Miwa, and after we were, you live for good. What we have again now?
You know the movie of Charlie's Angels.
Yeah, it's us. So yeah, we have like so multicultural group after.
Yeah.
Like Mexican and Japanese. But it was really, really fun. I think we are so lucky.
What's better? Because what's the time we prefer our English? Because
nobody speaks French. Yeah. Just you two.
French, our languages were totally different. So
that's why you. So it's. I think it's how we increase. We improve a lot our English.
You cannot tell her English
is really nice. Terrible. Our best memories together.
We have
a lot of memories.
The first one was in Christmas market, so like together.
Yeah, Christmas market was really nice.
The three of us, but the first memory, like you told me, I forgot it. In City Hall in the Lenny's of Toronto.
Yeah, there was a concert for the opening of ice skating. And yeah, we have so much memory. I think one was good for me. It was Christmas.
because I spent Christmas with Miwa. And after, when my Christmas with my hostel was finished, I went to her house.
Yeah, I invited her too.
Yeah, it was crazy because this day was like white Christmas.
Yeah, we had a white Christmas.
It was snowing a lot, but it was crazy. And she said at 11, oh, you can come to my house, we have party with my hostel.
Like, we had like people there in my home.
Yeah, I was like, okay, so I will put my boots, I will go to ski to her house. Yeah. Christmas in Canada is really nice because people invite, it's not only family, people invite a lot of friends. It's like kind of party. So yeah, we have really fun and it was nice. After was good, it's Niagara Falls, like frozen Niagara Falls.
We went to Niagara Falls when they were frozen. You have to know, I changed my class. I had my first class of business in English and my good friends told me, oh, we can go to Niagara Falls Frozen. And I said, no, it's my first class in business. Just skip it. You can go tomorrow. And I said, like, no, why? They combined me, but
worth it.
I missed my first.
But worth it.
Class. Yeah,
because we were like, yeah, you're gonna melt like the next day, so we need to go now. And like,
and they stay in like 1 week more. So,
but was nice, really nice memories. Really nice. After we have so much good party, I think we went to party like 2 times per week.
Yeah, we always like, have party on Thursday.
Yeah, Thursday, Madison. So it was funny because we were in Canada for winter. And yeah, it was frozen like minus 20. Yeah. And we still
went to Montreal.
Yeah.
And yeah, New Year. And the weather was like minus 32.
Yeah, it was really crazy. But it was funny because I remember we went to party when it was minus 20. And we were like with our
like
big jacket.
2 a.m.
With our big jacket, we have our dress. And after we with our big jacket, our cap, like the scarf, and we're like, okay, let's go party. So motivated. Really nice memory. Like Canada in winter, it's really hard, but yeah, I think it's worth it because we have so funny memories because of winter. If you have bad points about like when you go to an English school or in another country alone,
I don't know. Maybe you can. Well, if you're too shy, you will
not enjoy so much.
Yeah.
So yeah, don't be like you can be shy the first day, like I was. But yeah, don't say like this. Like just go to meet people because if you just stay home after, like I met some people like this. Like they were like to school and after they come back home and just read and watch TV. And I was like, no, like you need to enjoy some experience.
But I know that you go for study and practice. But the best practice is going out.
Yeah, for sure. Like my first teacher were right. Go out.
Yeah, that's true. That's
true. That was nice. One of the bad points for me is
food.
To say
food.
it's not what I was wanted to say, but yeah, food. Food in Canada is really like greasy and sweet. Like I miss so much my food, and for you it's the same. Like Mexican food is like unique. Yeah, for me, more like bad point is the goodbyes. You need to know that you will meet so much people in Canada if you go to this kind of school. And people will stay like a certain time, but not like you. For example, I was staying like 5-6 months, and like sometimes people just stay 1 month, 2 months, and you need to know that you need to say goodbye. What you do?
I know, I have a little hair here, and I was wondering what is that? It's my hair. Sorry.
It's not a mirror. It's a I wanted to say that. Yeah. To say goodbye is sometimes painful. Like I say goodbye when I leave for Canada, so to my family and to Berlin. The first time it was super sad. After you meet people in Canada and when you do say goodbye, it's super sad. It's really sad because you don't know if you're gonna meet people again. For example, if you meet people from, I don't know, from Japan, like they live at the end of the world, so you don't know when you will see them again. So you're like, okay, so bye-bye, you can come to my house, I can come to Japan, but we don't know when, like...
The good thing of that is that you will have a home in other countries.
Yeah, it's really painful sometimes because I think I cry a lot when I say goodbye. I cry when you leave. I cry when me when I leave. I spend my life to cry now because you always say goodbye to people. But it's unique memories, so but you need to think about it, but you will say goodbye to a lot of people. Ah yeah, and for sure one of the byproducts is that you're far from your family, so you need to know that you will be far for Christmas, for New Year,
for your birthday.
I was alone from not really alone, but I was not with my family for my birthday.
Thank you. I will let you alone then next time. Because you have to know,
my birthday was so nice.
You have to know. Remember, I stay more time because of your birthday.
Ah, it's true.
Yeah, it's supposedly I need to leave Toronto in December. But me and Noemi, her birthdays were on January, and they were telling me, please, it's
because
it's
a big party.
Like, no, I don't have money to stay more. Please. I said, okay, and I called my mom, can I? And I stay for them more time, like 1 month and a half.
And
ask if they stay or went to Mexico for my birthday. Of course not.
Because I was in Belgium after, so imagine Belgium, Mexico, it's expensive. But I'm here now for your birthday.
Thank you.
Yeah, you're far from my family, but you need to think that you have good friends to spend your birthday with. Like, for example, Christmas was a little bit sad, but it was crazy nice. Like New Year, because you met other people, everybody, it's the same situation. So, and yeah, the best point when you leave for Canada for like 6 months.
You have new friends around the world.
Yeah, it's
you I make very good people. You. And I think if you're so dedicated to that, if you go out and not stay at home, your English will be better.
Yeah.
And you need to keep practicing if you go back to your country, because
like me,
I will start to forget some words, and my chip, it's in Spanish, and I say, oh, how can I say like, I need to keep practicing to don't lose this.
Yeah, that's right. So that's why, yeah, you need to keep practicing. For example, I think it's 1 year and a half we know each other, and we speak every day by WhatsApp, every day, and we make call, and yeah, when someone is in a bad mood, like, we call each other, so you practice your English, and you decide you keep in touch, and now I'm in Mexico, so...
Good advice is, if you don't have, you don't want to text your friend or something like this, You can watch movies in English.
Yeah,
read in English.
So continue to like, for example, our phone is in English. Continue to watch movie in English, subtitle in English or not. Then yeah, for sure your mind will be in French. For example, for me, but after, you need to continue to read, to listen, and to speak in English.
Mm-hmm.
So as much as you can. I think it's a good thing.
You can repeat that. You need to keep practicing because of this.
Oh yeah, one good point for me, when you go to another country like this, is you can have like a new start. Like for me, I see my trip like this because I told you that my year before was really bad. I was kind of really lost in my life, and to come in Canada like allow me to be myself, to meet another people who can change a little bit my mind. And it was like a new start, because when you come to another country, nobody know who you are.
Yeah, I know.
You can be like really yourself.
You start to be confident with yourself.
Yeah, really. It's what my friends say when I came back in Belgium after, like, oh my gosh, you change a lot, but
it's
really
kind of mature.
Yeah, it's true. Like my friends say, you change a lot, you're like more confident on yourself. It's crazy, we can see it. Yeah, just be yourself with people. People will like you for who you are and don't know you.
Yeah, it's good because I told you before, the people there is friendly.
Mm-hmm.
They always hate each other.
Yeah.
Even if they don't know you. People.
Yeah, just don't be shy, be confident on yourself. If you have a bad moment in your life, maybe just go abroad. when you were sick can change a lot of things in your life.
My mind. So thinking changed too.
It changed my mind. See, my life totally different.
My plans changed after Canada.
Our life is terrible. Yeah.
For Canada, I have never planned to go abroad to another country. Yeah, so I didn't want it to go to Canada, so I said like, okay.
Oh, it's your parents.
Yeah, I said like my family. I was like, okay, I can go, I can try. Mm-hmm. So for me, it was like 3 months was a lot for me at first. Mm-hmm. And after, the time goes fast. And so like, okay, I need more time.
Yeah, the time goes too fast, really. It's crazy. In the beginning, you're like, oh my gosh, I will stay 6 months. It's too much.
6 months was like a lot. So I was like, oh, okay, I can't deal with that. So, but I'm not confident.
I can't deal with that. Yeah. It's okay. And finally, you will see when you meet people, the time flies.
You want to stay there.
Yeah, you are here for 6 months, you need to enjoy your 6 months because it's one time in your life.
Like, if you stay at home, that 6 months, you will feel like it's so long. But if you keep doing many things, many activities, the time will go fast.
Yeah. And after, the best question of this video, how is our English now?
You needed to listen to us before.
I want to know how I was before, like the first day when I speak with Miwa.
Maybe
like,
I
how was
like,
our English together?
So
vocabulary is the most complicated.
Yeah, but sometimes we didn't know the word in English, mm-hmm. and was like we describe it.
It's how you practice your English and you learn new vocabulary. Like I remember, like Miwa for example, she has a lot of vocabulary. So yeah, she every time when she speaks, I try to catch some words and. Yeah. I remember the words,
because you learn from the others.
If I see me when I was in high school, I think my English improved a lot. So I hope so. But after, yeah, for sure it's not perfect because our vocabulary, my French accent for me, yeah, it's another point. But I'm working in English now in Canada, so yeah, I'm able to do it. So I think everybody can do it, like. If you see me before, everybody can do it, seriously. For the advice part, and we're gonna finish this video after because it's so long time now and we need to go for an activity. Like, we are going to send out after. Advice, I think we speak about advice in all the video, but to sum up, I can say that...
Don't be shy.
Don't be shy, really. Like,
you're Laura.
Everybody is in the same case, so don't be shy, meet people, go out, be open-minded, like don't think about like, oh, in Belgium it's like this, I don't know how is it in Canada, oh, in Belgium it's like this.
Yeah, you're in another country, different culture.
Yeah,
you need to get used to the culture there and just respect them.
And it's why it's so nice because you can learn a lot about people. I learn a lot about Japanese culture, Latin culture, Mexican. So
party.
Yeah, I learned so much in just 6 months. So you can see another way to think, you know? So yeah, this kind of thing. And for sure, the best
the
point.
The most important advice is speak English.
Because you're in Canada for this and you pay because you need to know that it's expensive. Like to come here, I put all my economy in this trip because I really wanted to improve my English. So it's expensive, the school is expensive,
really
you need to pay
homestay,
but really worth it, seriously. I improve a lot, I met amazing people that I will never forget.
Money is the most important.
Like the people who gonna meet there, it's people you, I think it's people you're gonna keep for all your life. Because it's this kind of relationship, it's very special. So I think that's it for this video. So it was my first video like this. I hope it will look good.
I hope too. I hope you can understand me.
Understand?
Hope you can understand.
Yeah, I'm gonna put French subtitles. But yeah, I hope you...
It's time to practice your English. Don't read the subtitles.
just listen our English and you can say to us if our English is good or not.
So yeah, I hope you like it and this video can help you. If you need help, just comment the video and yeah, for sure we're gonna answer. You can answer too.
Yeah, I can answer in Spanish if you want.
Like you can contact me on like YouTube or Instagram.
If you want to know some words in Spanish, I can help you too. Bad words.
Thank you, Ale. So yeah, so bye bye. Bisous, bisous.
Bisous, bisous.
Bisous,
bisous. Bientôt.
I don't know how.